गुड मॉर्निंग. केस नंबर 2, 52 ईयर फीमेल विथ फेशियल नर्व पैल्सी, एफिनिसी एंड बायोप्सी ऑफ प्रीऑरिक्युलर स्वेलिंग. सेलुलर स्मियर स्टडीड शोज सेल्स अरेंज सिंगली एंड इन क्लस्टर्स सराउंडिंग हाइलिन ग्लोब्यूल्स ऑफ वेरिंग साइज. On high power, a spherical hyaline globule is noted, surrounded by uniform brown cells having hyperchromatic nuclei and coarse chromatin. My diagnosis on FNAC is adenocystic carcinoma because of the hyaline globules and round uniform cells surrounding the hyaline globules. Coming to histopathology, section studied shows well circumscribed lesion having cells arranged in cribriform pattern and in solid pattern. This is the cribriform pattern of arrangement. This is the solid pattern of arrangement. Here in this picture, section studied shows cells arranged again in cribriform pattern, and here we can see the pseudocysts which are formed are containing mucoid material. Section studied shows uniform round cells having hyperchromatic nuclei, prominent nucleoli and moderate to scant eosinophilic cytoplasm. These cells are arranged around cystic spaces containing mucoid material forming pseudocysts. My diagnosis is adenoid cystic carcinoma of the salivary gland. Adenoid cystic carcinoma is a slow-growing, highly malignant neoplasm with a remarkable capacity for recurrence. Grossly, solid appearance and an infiltrative pattern of growth, although some examples can be well circumscribed. Microscopically, three histologic patterns are typically encountered in these tumors, that is cribriform, tubular and solid. In cribriform pattern, there will be nests and columns of cells of rather bland appearance and are arranged concentrically around gland-like spaces, also called as pseudocysts, filled with homogeneous eosinophilic PAS positive material or granular myxoid material. Most of these are not true glandular spaces. They represent extracellular cavities containing reduplicated basal lamina material and mucin produced by the tumor cells. Small true glandular lumina are also formed, lined by a monolayer of eosinophilic epithelial cells. These are surrounded by varying amounts of small myoepithelial cells with scant cytoplasm and hyperchromatic angulated nuclei. This tumor has a remarkable tendency for invasion of perineural spaces. Some adenoid cystic carcinomas have a predominantly tubular pattern of growth, whereas others are mainly solid and yet others are sclerosing. The solid pattern is characterized by overgrowth of the epithelial or glandular component and frequently displays more mitotic activity with increasing cytologic urticaria with or without small foci of necrosis. Immunohistochemically, tumor cells in duct structures express a phenotype similar to that of the intercalated duct, that is positive for keratin, carcinoembryonic antigen, lysozyme, lactoferrin, alpha 1 anti-chymotrypsin, S100 protein and CD117, also known as c-kit. Cells around pseudocysts have a phenotype suggestive of myoepithelial cell differentiation, that is they are positive for S100 protein, p63 and actin and variably positive for keratin. Cytogenetically, there is a high incidence of loss of heterozygosity at chromosome 6q23 35. Differential diagnosis. Two differential diagnoses can be considered, that is benign mixed tumor and polymorphous low-grade adenocarcinoma. Benign mixed tumor, chondromyxoid stroma and focused squamous metaplasia can be seen. In addition, papillary growth and true cyst formation are not a feature of adenoid carcinoma, adenoid cystic carcinoma, whereas it can be seen in benign mixed tumors. Adenoid cystic carcinoma is invariably invasive and often associated with perineural invasion. Polymorphous low-grade adenocarcinoma. These are commonly seen in the major salivary glands. The nuclei are bland and uniform. Immunoreactivity for CD117 is either negative or shows a lesser intensity. These tumors can be graded into three grades: grade 1, grade 2, grade 3. Grade 1 has tubular or mixed cribriform and tubular patterns. Grade 2 is pure cribriform or solid component with less than 30%. Grade 3 is when there is more than 30% of solid component. And adenoid cystic carcinoma show these tumors show a hematogenous spread, and they often metastasize to the lungs, and most commonly and second commonly to the lymph nodes. In the lungs, they present as multiple nodules, but they can be asymptomatic, and they are not as aggressive as the primary tumor. Thank you.